Hey y'all, this is Wendy. This is Wendy's Parade. I do perfume reviews. So let's just get started. This is a perfume from 2001, 20 years ago, still around. That's hard to find, you know? Shit gets discontinued like in 6 weeks, it seems like nowadays. But we're going to be reviewing a perfume from Ungaro, Emanuel Ungaro, called Desnuda. Kind of a clear bottle there. There she is. 100 ml bottle. This is the box. Desnuda, Le Parfum, Emmanuel Ungaro. Okay, so enough of that. What this is. So a lot of people say that this is a, not a dupe, but it's in the same world as a 90s perfume from Christian Dior called Dolce Vita. So it's a warm, fruity, spicy, woody, and scentsy perfume. It's kind of in that, but people, it's probably in the oriental floral category. I know we're not allowed to say that anymore, I think. That's what I've heard anyway, but it's one of those things. So what does it smell like? If you like peaches, there's a lot of peach in this. It's very warm. And there's a lot of like foody notes, but I would not put this in the gourmand category because when this was made, this was before the whole gourmand thing. So even though there's tons of spices and tons of fruits and nice sweet things, it's not really gourmand. But it opens up with like a lot of peach and it's kind of dusted with cardamom and cinnamon and tuberose. Now, as that warms up, the most predominantly floral note, the floral heart is like a huge bouquet of flowers. The floral heart is mostly to my nose, mimosa and tuberose. And then kind of flitting in and out is rose and iris. But for the most part, it's kind of like this white floral bouquet that it's almost like it's a bouquet of flowers and there's a little bit of incense sitting like next to it. Like you're burning a stick of incense next to like a warm bouquet of flowers while eating dessert peaches, I guess. But so, and as this wears down even more, it becomes even smoother and rounder and more creamy in the woods. It's just beautiful. It has this nice sandalwood dry down, which I love sandalwood. So it has this beautiful sandalwood dry down and it kind of has like it still stays incense-y. So, and it still stays a little bit fruity. So you have that kind of stewed fruit reminiscence with some sandalwood and some incense. That's pretty much what this scent is. I think this is really feminine and really pretty. The sillage is very close to the body, but it lasts forever. And it definitely is one of those perfumes where if someone got close to you, they'd be like, oh my gosh, you smell so good. You know, just nice and classy in there, but not like, it's not going to be punching people in the face. It's just, it's not that loud. The other thing too, is that this has pretty good lasting power. One of those scents where if you put it on in the evening and you go to bed and you wake up, you're still going to smell the dry down. During the day, it probably lasts like 8+ hours. Now, the greatest thing about this is how freaking cheap it is because you know what? I watch all these videos and I'm just like, you know, oh, I got this haul. It's all Zerdroff and that cupcake perfume brand and, you know, Parfums de Marly and all this crap. And I'm like, how are y'all affording this? Like, it just blows my mind. But Miss Desnuda here is still in production from what I can tell. The company has changed hands a lot and it's now owned by this guy named Mr. Abdallah. And I'm not exaggerating. It's like this one person owns this perfume line now and is his Mr. Abdallah. But it's $20. This whole thing for 100 mils is $20 for an interesting, pretty, beautiful, well-made perfume progression. You know, good performance scents. It's cheaper than a freaking body spray at Target. And if you are not picky, I'm picky and I can't have this going on. I need the cap. I don't have to have the box, but it has to look right. If you're not picky and you're okay with the testers are like $12. I mean, $12 freaking. It's like nothing. I almost want to get a backup of this, but it's already 100 mils and, I wore this a lot, not last year, but the year before that in 2020, kind of a contentious year for everybody. Contentious year for everybody. And I was going through some things and I only had access to some of my perfumes at different times. And I wore this a lot in the spring and the winter of 2020. So, and then I had to put it away for a while. I needed a break, but she's back. And I just had to talk about her because she's my scent of the day. And Yeah, I would really go look at the reviews on Fragrantica for this. The reviews are like almost unanimously like, holy shit, this is an amazing scent. And if you're into like a mildly spicy, warm, fruity, white floral, woody dry down type of thing, I think Desnuda is your girl. But that's all I have to say about this. I don't know if anybody else, nobody seems to talk about this scent, so. Do you have any experience with this? Did you, I mean, if you want a dupe for, not a dupe, but if you miss La Dolce Vita from Dior, this is a good bet. Anyway, this has been another short, sweet, unedited perfume review from Wendy's Parade of Perfume. And any questions, comments, concerns, please leave them below, and I hope you're having a wonderful day.